Just got this in the mail. It is a Bark River Northstar EDC. Ordered it in green canvas micarta handles and holding it under light. This looks brown to me. I'm not sure if this will pick up very well. I'm sure it'll show up when I do a close-up. Not a big deal, but you know, I did order green and they sent brown. Whatever. The steel is CPM 3V. I've only got one other knife in this steel, and that is my Microtech Stitch. I have not sharpened that yet, so I have no idea how this steel behaves. I'm sure it's just like any other CPM steel. That is to say, it's pretty wear resistant. This is a full convex knife. However, they've got a secondary bevel on it that's quite large. I'm not sure if the light reflecting is actually showing you guys what I'm looking at. I'll bring you down here in just a minute and show you what I'm talking about. That secondary bevel is sharp, but it's not as sharp as it could be. If this entire bevel just came straight down to the edge with no secondary, it would be much better. Right now there's a few hitches in it. There's one in this area, there's one in this area, and then there's one in the tip. I'm not sure if it's going to pick up on camera, but I can feel it when I slice. Right there. Right there. Right there is one. Right there. There's a big one right there, though. Anyway, the point is, it's not as sharp as it could be. And because it's not a true convex, at least not a convex all the way to the edge, I am going to resharpen this. I'm going to put my edge on it. Bring you guys down and show you what I'm talking about on this secondary bevel. So as you can see, where that light is reflecting, it's basically just a secondary bevel. I don't know why they did that. They should have just made it a full convex. I watched a lot of Virtue Vice's videos and I've heard him talk about this and how Bark River puts a secondary micro bevel on. And I fully understand what he's talking about now. It really takes away from the performance of what the knife is capable of. But at the same time, it just reinforces the strength of the edge. So if you're, you know, using the knife in situations and ways you probably normally wouldn't, this edge will hold up a little stronger than a true convex will. Regardless, I'm going to do what I do. I'm going to use my Shapton Pro stones. I'm just going to follow Virtue Vice's recommendations. 1K, 2K, 5K, and then strop. I've got to go grab my 2K stone, so I'll be right back. Like I said, I've never sharpened this steel before, so I have no idea how it's going to behave. To be pretty wear resistant. cut my fingers off. Wow, this stuff is much more wear resistant than I thought. I don't know how he does it with just a 1K sound so quickly. Alright, I'm slowly getting that line of light to disappear. Got a little bit here, here, and at the very tip. Thank you. Got a little bit of a burr at the tip. I'm trying to break it off because it's starting to crumble. I don't want it to deform my shape. Wow, this stuff is much tougher than I thought. Just about there. Got two spots right here with a little bit of that shining light right where my fingers are. Storm. It was a thunder. All Alright, I got just the slightest amount left. All right, finally. What's some tough ass steel? I think it would have been better to start on maybe 320 grit just to get that initial grinding out of the way. Thank you. I can see if I sharpen this knife again, I'm definitely going to have to put a sharpening notch in. This lip right at the very back is causing, pretty much like every other knife, a recurve. I'm having trouble just getting down to the apex back there because of that. I think that's got it though. As long as the very edge of the edge is good, the rest of it, it's just aesthetics. I'll of course bring you guys down and show you. See where we are before stropping. Sorry about that, guys. My video ran out of space, or my phone ran out of space, rather. That's how it should cut. Much better. But I'm not totally happy with it. I may have to go back over this again with the 2 and then maybe the 5K. Back here especially, I'm going to put a sharpening notch in. And I'm going to have to go back over this guy. of fact, I think that's what I'm fixing to do. Alrighty guys, I am back. I put a sharpening notch in this guy, and I got that edge all the way to the base. I got this looking much better than where it was. Now those scratches can be taken out with just some sandpaper if I so wanted to, but the scratches don't bother me. It just makes the knife my own. Plus I got this guy to use. I plan to use and, well, not abuse, but I do plan to use the hell out of it at work. Trying to make sure there's no issue in the back of the cutting edge here. Keep catching the sharpening notch though. Appears to be fine. If I find out different, all I'll do is bring it back to the strop. I'll raise my angle ever so slightly and just go back over the strop a few times. Bring the edge back, and what that'll do is slowly over time that'll increase the apex angle. It'll actually make the apex fatter, and in doing so it'll make it stronger. And I'll keep doing that until I finally reach the point where I'm no longer getting damage and it reaches a little bit of an equilibrium. And by that point, it should stay for quite a while, considering this is 3V. But as I strop, it'll fatten up more and more until the point where it's just, you know, really obtuse, at which point I'll take it back to the 1K stone, reset the apex, go back through the whole process, and thin it out. Anyway, appreciate you guys watching. Y'all have a good one.